Due to illness, the roles of the nice guys on Business Today will be played by Rocky and Bullwinkle.
And so there's a level of passion of an idea that you have, of a business that you started. The problem is that most people, the more that they move forward with that idea or that business, that the passion or the purpose can slowly but surely fade away because life happens.
So I was sitting in my cubicle today and I realized ever since I started working, every single day of my life has been worse than the day before it. So that means that every single day that you see me, that's the worst day of my life. At least until I listen to the Nice Guys on Business podcast.
Need an education on how to grow your business? The Nice Guys are here to help. Learn about great customer service, networking, and how just being nice can help you prosper. Now, here are your hosts, Doug Sandler and Strickland Bonner.
Hey, Funkin' fans, welcome back, welcome back. It's Monday. I'm kind of exhausted from the weekend, actually.
This was a long weekend. Did you only work one event, or did you have several?
I only worked one event, but I got caught up on a bunch of turnkey stuff on Sunday, and the one event I had was like an hour and a half away in a vineyard in Virginia. I don't know why.
Let me ask a question, just from my. When you go to jobs, and your clients, because all of your clients are partying and having a good time, they're insisting, of course, that you have a drink. Also, do you ever drink at events?
No, I never drink at events.
Right. I'm the same way. But don't you? How many clients of 10 clients? How many always? How many say? Would you want to drink?
Oh yeah, they often do all the time. Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah, because you're just a part of the party, aren't you? I mean, you're not working. You're actually just having a good time.
Right. Absolutely. No, you're right. And I don't. I mean, we don't drink when we're playing. I mean, I don't know about you. You don't drink when you're playing, right?
No. I can't. I'm mostly around kids when I'm actually working. So no, I don't drink at all when I'm working.
Right.
Anyway, so today is interview day. We have Rob Holman on the show today, right?
Yeah, that is correct. Rob Holman, his website is Rob Holman, that's with two B's, robbholman.com. And it is all about inside-out leadership.
I love the areas that he helps you focus on: core values, your strengths, your passions, your milestones, and your gifts in life as a way to determine the type of leader that you are. So nice interview. Rob is an assertive guy. I mean, he is a guy that definitely you feel like he is a leader's leader. I don't understand the term necessarily inside out leadership, and he kind of gets into what inside out means. And then I kind of get this, but he really does help you focus on those five areas, especially your core values. If you understand what your core values are, you really do learn a lot about your leadership style. And he does a good job explaining that right on the show today.
Cool. And we have a sponsor today too, right?
Yeah. Sponsor today is Interview Valet. If you decide that you want to become a guest on podcast, or if you think that podcasting is the way to promote your message, you definitely want to check out Interview Valet. They have a number of different packages that you can buy into and subscribe to. If you are someone that wants to share your message on podcast, kind of like the Nice Guys on Business, we've had a lot of really great guests that have come to us, like Yigal.
What's Yigal's?
Yeah. What a great, a really good. How do you say his last name?
Isn't it Edota? Yigal Edota?
Just a good guy. I mean, there's many guys like Yigal that are out there in the audience.
Trying to look him up to find the episode number, but I can't spell his name right.
You know what?
Oh, there it is. Y-I-G-A-L, episode 341.
I think that if everyone that wants to be a guest on the show.
I think
everybody that wants to come on our show needs to have a last name like Smith or Holman. Holman's a pretty easy name to remember. Rob Holman. See, a nice, easy name to remember. He had to throw the extra B in there.
I thought we were talking about Interview Valet.
Oh, we were.
The extra B is there for value. No, I'm not sure why it's there.
It stands for best. You are the best leader that we have.
Makes sense.
Yeah. So anyway, let's just finish up the message about Interview Valet. Promote your message using podcasting as your tool. Tom Schwab and his entire gang over at Interview Valet. We'll put a link in the show notes so that you can go there to see what they're all about. But podcasting is definitely a very cool way to promote your business. And obviously it is so because you are listening because you like podcasts.
Or you like us. Maybe they hate podcasts.
Yeah, that's
like
true.
Us.
You know, if you meant to tune into XM and you actually found us by mistake, what station are we on? What station would you want to be on if you were on?
I'd want to be on 39, which is Hair Nation.
Really?
Yeah, love that.
I kind of want to be on Coffee House. That's 14. I like Coffee House.
Hey, channel 14 is the Coffee House. These are the That's nice, like, sweet, mellow acoustic versions of every song that you've heard on Hair Nation. Yes.
It's like it's the nice guys unplugged.
Right. That's exactly.
So B,
it would just be like us yelling into the microphone from all the way over here.
See, this is us. This is us on Hair Nation.
This is us on Coffee House.
Which one do you love? What do you like better?
I think we ought to get back to Interview Valet because we keep getting distracted, and they are a sponsor today.
We're good. Just click on the show notes. You'll get to Interview Valet if you want to see more about being a guest on a podcast to promote your business. InterviewValet.com. Tom Schwab and the gang. Excellent group over there. Okay, I think we're ready to get to our interview now.
You sure with Rob Holman with the extra B for the best?
Yeah. He wants to just get to his episode. He doesn't want any of these shenanigans that we're going through right now. Straight.
I think you're probably right, yeah.
You know that. Well, this is Monday, so we actually are, it's a slow ramp up to the week. You probably still are drunk from the weekend, right?
No, I worked over the weekend. I don't have time to get drunk. I'm too busy editing. Oh,
I had three gigs this weekend. I am exhausted.
Yeah, that's crazy. I did only one. You got me beat on that by a long shot. Yeah.
Yeah, but I have a lot less equipment I got to lug around. I mean, it probably takes you four times longer just to set up the stuff that you have to set up.
Yeah, probably.
And I do have help.
Right.
Yeah, I go about it the unfair way. I take advantage of every possible opportunity to get someone to lift shit for me because I don't want to do it.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
All right, let's get to the interview. Rob Holman right here on the Nice Guys on Business podcast. How would you like to live the life of a leader and not just a manager of people, but actually be a transformational leader, a leader that makes a huge impact and live a life on purpose and serve with purpose as well? So today's guest, Rob Holman, he's an expert in the leadership space. His goal is to prove to you that you and everyone actually in our Nice Guy community, including you, Strickland, can actually have the ability to be a leader. So welcome, Rob, to the Nice Guys on Business podcast.
Doug, great to be with you. Excited to share my heart with you today, and hopefully we won't get in too much trouble together. So.
Oh, no, that's not good. We want to get in a lot of trouble today. We're gonna try to get us off the rails as quickly as we possibly can while still sharing a bit of your message.
I'm definitely on the right show then, for sure.
Hey, I love the fact, as soon as I started talking to you, I love the fact that you said, I've been listening to your podcast, and actually, I'm used to the tone and the quality of what you guys are all about, which, you know, was like a quality level of -3. So what was it that after you listened to the show, you said, you know what, I'm still going to go through with this interview?
You know, I love people that make me nervous. So at the end of the day, I'm a firm believer in like getting comfortable with the uncomfortable. And so I love to put myself in environments where there's a level of spontaneity. You never know exactly what's going to come out. However, you know, you're going somewhere together, but you might not know exactly where until the end of the show.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
So I love to surround myself with people like yourself, like Strickland, like other people that, you know, go after things. And, but yet there's a level of focus at the same time. And I love the stretching of meeting new people and engaging in new conversation because there's a newness, there's a freshness to that, and you can't help but grow as a natural result.
You know, you just put a really fine veneer on top of our entire podcast, which actually makes us sound a little bit more legitimate than we actually are. You don't have any PR in your background, do you?
No, not at all.
So it sounds good though. Hey, so let me get into it with you because I feel like, and I think I said this to you as we were talking just before I hit the record button, I feel like I've really gotten to know you just in the last few hours of watching pretty much every video that you've put out and reading a whole bunch of stuff that you've done. It's easy to sense that leadership isn't an industry that you just work in, but a part of your everyday life and a lot of what you are passionate about. And it comes through so easily on the videos because I sense that you're pushing your voice to the point where I believe you. So why is that such a case? And why is this such a position that you have passion about in your life?
It goes back to me in my college years, way back in the day and leading up to my senior year of college, which is about 20 years ago. Purpose for me was nothing more than going out and hanging out with the guys and drinking and winning the next basketball game because they played college basketball. That was it for me.
Yeah.
And up until, you know, my senior year of college where I actually had to deal with some really difficult, you know, circumstances, I actually had a tumor in my abdomen that actually went undiagnosed for about a month and a half. And this is, we're getting ready for the season, basketball season, my senior year. I'm age 21. It's supposed to be the best year of your life.
Right.
And here I come down with this undiagnosed condition. All I know is that it's extremely painful. And I got CAT scans, MRIs, and they couldn't figure out what it was. It was like they weren't ruling out cancer. They didn't know exactly what to do with it, how to treat it, until I saw an ultrasound specialist. I live right outside of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. And I saw this ultrasound specialist at UPenn Hospital. And I went in to see him. And we had all the previous test results from all my other, you know, tests I'd gotten taken from all over the place. And when he checked me out, he was dumbfounded. He couldn't believe when he took a look at the screen what he saw. Right. And he saw absolutely nothing. And he said, whatever you came in with, I cannot describe what I'm even saying to you, but you leave with nothing.
Wait. So hold on a sec. So yeah. You had all this pain and you went to these other doctors and they said you have a mass or something. Yeah. And you go to this guy that does an ultrasound to actually take a solid look at it. And he says, yeah. I don't have any. You don't have anything.
You don't have anything. And the most bizarre thing, Doug, I kid you not, when he shared that with me the first time, it hadn't even registered because I'm like, what do I need to do? I just want the pain to go away. And now he says it, and he obviously has my undivided attention at this point, but I'm a little confused. He says, Rob, look at the ultrasound screen. I'm going to show you that you clearly do not have anything. And when he told me this time, showing me very specifically, and as I'm looking at the screen, that I did not have anything,
right.
All I got to say is, it's like in the depth of my heart and soul, like fireworks were going off.
Right.
And I was like, from that point forward, it literally changed the entire trajectory of my life. I now purpose coming out of this miraculous set of circumstances that doctors still to this day cannot describe actually what happened. You better believe I was asking a whole different set of questions than I was asking going into this appointment.
So in other words, what you're saying is, and again, I'm not trying to make this a woo-woo subject here, but it's what it sounds like. It sounds like the original doctors, they had a diagnosis. They probably were right. But by the time you got to have this ultrasound, whatever it was, whatever this miracle, this divine intervention that was going to happen in your life happened. And that changed your entire perspective and outlook on life?
Completely. And so now purpose in life was going from winning the next basketball game to hanging out with the guys and going drinking and having a good time. Now I started to ask questions like, hold on a second. Now I'm 21 years old.
Yeah. What is my life really about?
Yeah. What's my life really about? Why am I here on earth that may be uniquely different from a bunch of other people?
Right.
And that literally changed everything for me. And it wasn't like a necessarily an overnight thing, but I started a self-discovery process that has led me now 20 years since that happened. You know, that was the start of really, I graduated from college. I started my professional basketball career. I started my first business at age 21, had two companies by the age 23. And that slowly but surely, as I started to discover who I was able to start helping other people, other leaders, other business owners discover who they are.
So help me just for, again, a quick second here, just because I want to make this as relatable as I can to the Nice Guy community, those that are listening in our audience. And it's like, well, wait a second. You know, Rob, I haven't had a life-altering event or a miracle that has come into my life. This is something, of course, you can do it because you had this thing that happened in your life. How do I find that passion in my life? I've just been a normal guy. I've gone through my entire life. I haven't had anything dramatic or very significant happen to me. As a matter of fact, I feel like I'm living a life of insignificance. Yeah. And when somebody says that, how do you get them to have some level of relatability as to what happened in your life and translate it and what could happen in their
life? Great question. And it all begins with understanding that every person, it's more of an awareness thing. It's like every good thing begins with awareness. And we've got to come to the understanding that each person listening to this podcast, out of 7.5 billion people on planet Earth. Now, I don't know about you. There's been a whole lot of people before this present time. There'll be a whole lot of people most likely after the present time. I mean, even people figured out there's been approximately slightly over 100 billion people that have ever lived on the Earth. If we can begin to grasp, out of 100 billion people, 7.5 billion that live today, that there's no one like you. No one's wired the way you are. No one loves people the way that you do, serve people the way that you do, solve problems the way that you do. No one's had unique set of life circumstances in the same way that you have. And if you're sitting here today, standing here today, living and breathing, then you have specific and unique purpose for you that sets you apart from everyone else on planet Earth. If we can have even begin to taste of that level of awareness, now we start to say, okay, what am I most passionate about in life? And many of the listeners, you know, are obviously business leaders, business owners, entrepreneurs. And so there's a level of passion of an idea that you have, of a business that you started. Mm-hmm. The problem is that most people, the more that they move forward with that idea or that business, that the passion or the purpose can slowly but surely fade away because life happens. So I just want to encourage people, because I've seen this alarming statistic, not just based on my own experience being an entrepreneur, but also just legitimate stats out there of the average employee, the average worker, about 90% of them are disengaged from their work. And then the leaders of those workers, the entrepreneurs, the business owners, the supervisors, the managers, the leaders of them, about 80% of people are disengaged from their work on a consistent basis. So, and let me describe or define disengagement: a lack of meaningful and consistent purpose and passion in what they do day in and day out. So I want to see that reignited so businesses can prosper and communities can be impacted.
So how do you get from 20 years ago or so, what it happened, I'm assuming in your, you know, it happened, you were in your early 20s, like you said. So that's 20 or some years ago that happened to you. How is it that you can wake up every morning with that same joy of life, that you can recall that specific set of circumstances that happened to you? I mean, what is it that drives you today every morning to wake up and be who you are?
Simply, it's gratitude. I think when we can learn the discipline of gratitude, waking up, this is me every day. I wake up every day. Listen, we all have a bad night's sleep on occasion. Sometimes we have more well-rested nights, but we all wake up and the eyeballs go, they just pop right open. And if we're not careful, we get sucked in to, you know, checking social media, returning phone calls, email, going to the news. And we know how negative a majority of that stuff is. So what I've decided to do is I want to take the bull by the horns and take control of my day. And I call it the first fruits of my day. So as soon as my eyes open, I give intentional thanks. You know, God, this is what I'm thankful for. I'm thankful that I'm breathing. I'm thankful for my wife. I'm thankful for my kids. Thankful for my house. I'm thankful for the opportunity to hopefully inspire a couple people today. Thank you for the meetings. Thank you for meeting Doug today and getting to know him a little bit better. I know. I don't know how many people say that to you, Doug, but.
Not many. not many, Rob, not many.
So all of a sudden I start intentionally giving thanks. Then I go downstairs and grab my cup of coffee. And trust me, you don't want to see me on more than one cup of regular a day. But
I can only imagine that.
So I go down and get my coffee, and all of a sudden my kids, because I'm an early riser, they start trickling downstairs. And we just, it's a major family value, not just personal value, but family value to give thanks to begin our day. So before long, my son, I have three kids, wife, and before long, our entire family, before we get wrapped up in the rat race of the day, we're all giving thanks. And some mornings it's 10 minutes and some mornings it's an hour. And we have fun with it. We act it out. We can draw stuff. We speak out loud. And so every day, and I'm a firm believer, when we give intentional thanks, whether it's 5 minutes or 50 minutes every single morning, it sets the tone for the day. Now we go about our day looking for the good, regardless of the curveballs that life throws at us.
And what's so amazing about what you're saying, Rob, and Nice Guy Community, this is a valuable lesson for us all to learn, is that kindness, gratitude, empathy begets kindness, gratitude, and empathy. The more empathetic and kind that you are, and the more gratitude that you show, the more whatever you put out there in the world. And I know that we have a number of people that come on the show and share the message of just be nice, just be kind, just show empathy, just be grateful for what you have in your life. It's amazing the consistency of that level of person that comes on the show with the level of success that they achieve in life. It's not by accident. This happens on purpose. Yeah. What I love so much about your message is that becoming a transformational leader, actually developing into a leader of any kind, but a leader that has transformational capacity among them. It is amazing that it is all about how you approach the people that are in your world, and becoming a transformational leader is all about that. So can you share just a little bit about how the leadership role fits into the process that you go through, even with your kids? Yeah. Because I see that evolving into becoming a transformational leader.
Absolutely. So again, if you live a life, you're committed to live a life of gratitude, you're looking for the good in every situation, regardless of the challenges, the trials, the tribulations. And listen, we all live life. They're going to come. But now you go about it from a different perspective. I call it a higher perspective. You go about your day now with a firm foundation under your feet of good things, of great things. And you can't help in the midst of that as you spend time with people. You know, I spend time with my kids. I spend time with my wife. When you have the good in mind at the forefront and the center, now you're not looking for the bad. Now you're not going down those roads of negativity. You're keeping focus on the good in every situation, in every person, and you're quick to point those things out in them. So even, let me get real practical on the personal front and also business front. So let's say my son, let's say he's doing things that annoy me. But if I'm grateful for him and I keep that at the forefront and center, I'm going to be much quicker to point out the good. And son, you know what? This is what I see in you. And you just keep on keeping on this. And I won't pay as much attention to the negative or the ways that he's trying to rub me the wrong way and not listen to dad, but I'm going to focus on the good. Now there's seeds planted in him that are, I believe, are going to give, bring about more life in time. And I'm going to be, it'll give me an opportunity to speak more life over my son, encourage him. Now let's move ourselves right into the business world. These are principles that whether you're in the home or the business, you are who you are regardless of where you go. And so it breaks the levees down of like boxing in, well, here's my personal life. And then over here, I'm going to put this hat on and be my, you know, be the business coach, your boss or manager. So now in the business world, if all of a sudden you are quick to point out the good that your workers, your team members are doing, you know, they're just looking to be inspired, encouraged. And let me just tell you something. When you intentionally tell someone, tell a coworker, a team member, or a strategic partner of the things you see in them that they're doing really, really well, that empowers them. That empowers them to want to do that even better and become even more efficient and effective in what they do. As a natural byproduct, whether it's my son and my family or whether it's a coworker or a team member, as a natural byproduct, there's tremendous fruit that comes with productivity in time.
What's amazing about what you're saying, again, I have to really applaud you for the not only your message, but how you're presenting it as well. I can tell you have this level of passion, Rob, that is just unmatched by many people that not only just come on the show, but the people that I run into in the course of just doing consulting and speak all, you know, fortunately, I'm able to speak all over the country and seeing the attitudes among the people that are out there when I'm talking to them in the networking meetings. I mean, it is so interesting how that's a part of your everyday makeup. I really do go through this process of trying to catch people in the act, and it's the act of doing something right as opposed to catching them in the act of doing something wrong. And I think that by positively reinforcing those proper things and showing gratitude, they want to do better. They want to do better things for you, and they want to be around you, and they want to help you to be an even better leader, because maybe leadership is not for them, at least in that particular moment in time. They're okay with looking up to somebody like you as their leader. And by you showing gratitude, again, it's just one of the things that really helps you just to become a better leader over and over and over.
And
again,
Doug, I got to share this with you. When people, some people hear this message and they're like, hold on, Rob, as a leader, aren't you being soft? Like, let's say there are people that need to, I mean, honestly, right? Like that seems like a soft position.
Listen, nice guys finish first, I always say. And they're like, well, wait a minute, it's nice guys finish last. I'm like, well, you don't know where the finish line is.
There you go. I told you, as you very well know, you always go somewhere in this podcast. But, you know, when you speak life, you know, I'm a firm believer, we either speak life or death over ourselves and over other people. But when we choose to speak life and point out the good, everything we've been talking about, I am a firm believer and under the strong conviction that out of that place, people are going to be much more receptive to constructive criticism, because now they know that you're for them, not against them. Mm-hmm. Now they know that you stand in their corner, and when they get knocked down, you'll be the first one to come up and lay out your hand to them and say, come on and get up with me. We're going to do this thing together. And I just find with that positive reinforcement, that affirmation, that encouragement, that empowering voice and presence in someone's life, that's the place where great things happen.
Yeah. Gosh, I love it. I love it. You got me excited about my day, you know, just get my day started right now. So it brings me to an interesting point, because a lot of what I'm seeing and you're talking about in the videos and I'm reading about through your blog and through some other spots where I'm reading information about you, you talk about living this life on purpose, leading me to believe really that most people don't, they don't make life happen. They kind of let life happen. So can you share a little bit of your view on that?
Yeah. So I've had the honor and the privilege, the joy to travel and speak out of country a number of times. And I've traveled to the Middle East quite a few times. And, you know, the number one question I'm asked many questions when I travel over the world, but especially the Middle East, you can imagine the amount of questions, the kind of questions I'm asked. and mm-hmm. Political questions, how tall I am because I'm 6'4". What would bring me over there to that region of the world? But the number one question that I'm asked in that region of the world is, who am I? People want to know who Rob Holman truly is. Now, what do you think the number one question I'm asked in America, in my own neck of the woods, in my own backyard is?
Why? I don't know. Why are you so tall? I'm so tall too. Right. So I was like, how is it being so tall? That's the question
I'll always get. That's definitely at the top. But the number one question is, I don't think any one of us is removed from this, is what do you do? And it's interesting. Yeah. In the eastern part of the world, people want to know who I am. And the western part of the world, they want to know what I do. We can easily get wrapped up and allow what we do to define who we are. And purpose is all about discovering or rediscovering who we are. See, I'm a firm believer that when we understand and we go on a self-discovery process of understanding who we are, then we can begin to ask the question, why do I exist? That's true purpose. And so I've discovered five things that help us understand kind of who we are. Number one, do you know what your personal core values are? Second, what are your top strengths? Third, what are your greatest passion areas, the things that have you leaping out of bed every morning to do? Fourth, what are your life milestones, the things in your life, both good or bad, that have happened to where at the point of time in which they happened, a stake was put in the ground and you knew that you would never, ever be the same. Yeah. Fifth and final is, what do you feel is the primary gift that you've been given in life? Are you just a born leader? Are you an encourager? Are you a gifted teacher? And these gifts aren't as much meant for you. They're meant for other people. So that when you're no longer on earth anymore, it's a legacy you leave behind. If we can begin to be encouraged and build up with understanding who we are through those five unique areas, then we start out of that place of knowing experientially who we are and being encouraged and affirmed out of that place. Now we can start to say, okay, why do I exist that's uniquely different from 7.5 billion people on the planet? And when we can begin to walk in that place and follow along that journey and begin to own that for ourselves, that's where true leadership begins. Now we don't have to try to pretend to be someone else. Now we own who we are. We own our own space. We stay in our own lane. And that's the most effective way to lead other people, because now it's a genuine sense of confidence. It's a genuine sense of authenticity. And this is when big things can begin to happen. We can rally people for great causes that have a ripple effect to affect future generations.
Amazing stuff, man. Hey, if somebody in our community wanted to get a hold of you to find out a little bit more, and you have a book coming out too, Lead the Way, right?
Book's coming out shortly. I'm excited about it. Yeah.
I am excited about it also. I know that, and I think you are self-publishing the book, and I have to tell you, as you probably know, in the self-publishing world, or really in any, whether you're going through traditional publishing or not, because regular publishers don't do shit to help you kind of promote the book anyway. So, it's all about, I'm sure it's written very well, but now we got to get that book marketed. So 80% marketing, 20% writing skills. Do you agree with that?
I totally agree with that, man. Yeah.
Jeez, it's coming out soon. I know that's an exciting time. So, how can people get more information about you and your book that's coming out?
So about me, I do a lot of speaking and a lot of content driven stuff, as you can imagine, because as you've experienced on this call and on this podcast, I'm not afraid to share my heart and I get very passionate about the things I believe in. So two ways people can get in touch with me. One is, robholman.com, Rob's with two B's, robholman.com. And then the book is leadthewaybook.com.
Excellent. We'll make sure that we put information about both the book and Rob in the show notes, Nice Guy Community. So if you want to get a hold of Rob, find out how he can come out to your organization or your institution or your business, or if you just want to get you do coaching.
Yeah,
also,
do a little bit of coaching, a bit more selective with coaching this season of my life with helping raise three young kids and a lot of speaking I do, but I do it on occasion as well. So I enjoy it.
So the important thing, are you South Philly or are you where?
We're west of Philadelphia and probably about 25 miles outside in one of the suburbs called Westchester, Pennsylvania.
I know it well. Had spent a lot of time in Fort Washington in my early 20s. So, loved it there. So if you ever get into Philly itself. Are you a Pat's? Are you Geno's? Are you Jim's cheesesteaks? What's your cheesesteak of favorite?
Let me just tell you, man, Jim's on South Street.
Yeah.
I'm a huge Jim's fan. And I'll tell you why, Doug, primarily because they chop up their steak. I'm going to get real specific now.
You want to know
the real stuff now. No, I love Jim's. I mean, there's tons of great steak places, but Jim's is by far the best for me.
Yeah, well, Jim's for me is the best because they legitimately put Cheese Whiz on your cheesesteak too. And you can get the onions and they're chopped up really nice. The other nice thing about it is they actually have seating upstairs and you can stay in that downstairs area where they have all the star photos, the people that have been there. But man, I love Jim's. Now, if I'm in Atlantic City though, I do like to go to the White House. I don't know if you know the White House subs that they have.
Man, now see, we're getting in some serious conversation.
I love Philadelphia. I really did. I lived in just outside of Cherry Hill in a town called Maple Shade for several years and spent a lot of time dating girls, getting married, getting divorced, doing it all right in the Philadelphia area. So
good, man.
Really, really fun. How old are your kids?
Well, yeah, I have a 9-year-old, soon to be 7-year-old. She's going to be 7 in November. She's 6 right now. And then a 21-month-old. And I'm 42. I feel like I'm just starting life. So.
Oh, you are totally just getting underway. Don't forget the 529 plan. Very important for college savings. Just start. If you haven't started it yet, even $100 a month for each of those kids would be valuable down the road. I'm telling you, I did it. I have two kids. Mine are 21 and 24. And by the time these kids got out of college, if I did not save the money that I had through the 529, I would have been completely bust. I mean, college is like, a cheap college is $25,000 and $30,000 a year.
Well, I'll tell you now, knowing your kids are so much older than mine, I'm going to be giving you a call for wisdom, Doug. That's
hey, I'm calling you for leadership lessons, man. You can call me for wisdom. I'll be happy to give you all my gray hair. That's for sure. Awesome. Hey, man, Rob, I appreciate you being on the show today. Any final words? Any final advice that you can give to our nice guy
community? You know what? It's just been a joy to be with you. And at the end of the day, to all the listeners, you know, spend time getting to know yourself and be as honest as possible and be willing to go on a self-discovery process. And so you can only find the seeds of greatness that are on the inside of you.
Oh, man. Great, great final words. Rob Holman, thank you for being on the show today. Nice guy community. Never underestimate the value of nice. Again, all of his information and his links will be in our show notes today. Thanks again, Rob.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
For the Nice Guys on Business, I'm Steve O'Brien. Fill up your week with the Nice Guys. Trust me, this is going to hurt me a lot less than it's going to hurt you.